The final book in the Alphabet Squadron Trilogy, Victory's Price by Alexander Freed, is out today. I really enjoyed the first two books, so how does this one compare? Here are my spoiler-free thoughts, sponsored by Audible. In short, I loved it. Alphabet Squadron is one of my favorite canon books. I liked Shadowfall a lot, but not quite as much as the first in the series, and I would say Victory's Price is probably somewhere in between. Over time, I could see it rising to become even with the first book, but really, I have to admit that these books are a trilogy. They work together seamlessly to tell one long story. It kind of reminds me of something like Lord of the Rings, which, sure, is broken into three books, but it's clear what the story was from the start. Victory's Price is an insanely satisfying conclusion to story beats established over the previous two books. Now, it is also super up my alley because I love pilot stories. I was inclined to like this trilogy from the start. I'd be hesitant to say Victory's Price or the other two books are for any and every Star Wars fan. Looking at something like Light of the Jedi, I would 100% recommend every fan at least give it a try. The Alphabet Squadron books are different. They're very personal, they're thoughtful. Even though they're not overly long, I find them to be much more difficult reads. It just took me more time to get through it because it's heavy. While there are, of course, great dogfights, starfighter action scenes, and very creative locations for battles, they aren't the highlight of the books for me. Every single book in the trilogy, I feel like I'm a quarter of the way into it, and I'm not convinced I like it, but then there will be one scene where everything just clicks for me, and I get it. I don't think that's what every Star Wars fan is looking for. Honestly, it's usually not what I'm looking for in a Star Wars book. I like learning new revelations, new lore, all that good nerdy stuff. And there's very little of that in any of these three books, but especially Victory's Price. When it comes time to update the big canon timeline video I do every year, Alphabet Squadron won't take up much time, but I find the characters, their story, and the real-world questions these books bring up to be so good, I just don't care. If you liked the first two Alphabet Squadron books, you will almost certainly love Victory's Price. If you like pilot stories, or a book that will really challenge you and make you think, you'll definitely get that here. But if you're looking for new lore or revelations about the galaxy, or Operation Cinder, or how the Emperor somehow survived, that's not what these books are about. They're about seven characters and how war has affected them, and as the title suggests, the third book specifically asks what the price of victory is. The Empire is notorious for achieving their goals no matter the cost, but what about when they start to be on the losing side? Why would they go along with something like Operation Cinder? Why keep committing genocides and atrocities for a dead emperor? Maybe it's because a New Republic victory would mean having to face the consequences of their actions. Maybe it's because failing would mean all those terrible things someone did would have ultimately been for nothing. Maybe it's both. The book deals with guilt and personal growth and forgiveness in a very Star Wars way, with war and crazy heightened stakes. When does someone go too far to be beyond forgiveness? I think the book argues it's when they lose the capacity to examine themselves, admit they might have been wrong about something, and then commit to being better. But it also argues that forgiveness is personal and doesn't mean there won't be any consequences. Again, this is a very heavy Star Wars read in my opinion. I think I'll do a full-on spoiler review later because I want to talk about these themes more in depth, but I don't want to spoil anything for the book on day one of its release. Like I said earlier, this video is brought to you by Audible. Audible is a leading provider of audio content and is a service we use all the time because we go through a lot of Star Wars audiobooks. I love all the Star Wars audiobooks because they're big productions with music and sound effects, so it's like listening to a movie. You can get Victory's Price right now by visiting www.audible.com/StarWarsExplained or by texting Star Wars Explained to 500-500. If you sign up for a free 30-day trial today, you'll get a credit for one free audiobook of any price and full access to the Plus catalog absolutely free. The Plus catalog contains thousands of select audiobooks, podcasts, Audible originals, and more. Once you get an audiobook or audio drama, it will always be yours. You own that piece of content even if you cancel your membership, and if you get an audiobook you don't like, you can swap it out thanks to Audible's Great Listen Guarantee, which gives you up to a year to exchange an audiobook you didn't like for one you're excited to keep. That offer lasts for as long as you're a member. You can use your credit for Victory's Price, or all the other canon novels have audiobooks out right now. If you've been wanting to get into Star Wars audiobooks, now is the perfect risk-free time to try. Get one audiobook and full access to the Plus catalog absolutely free. Visit audible.com/StarWarsExplained or text Star Wars Explained to 500-500. But that's it for today. If you haven't already, please like this video, subscribe to the channel to keep up with all our Star Wars coverage, follow us on Twitch, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook, and consider checking out our Patreon page. As always, thanks for watching, and may the Force be with you.